Did you know that you can use Kubernetes to manage TLS certificates for applications running outside the Kubernetes cluster? If not, in this short tutorial, I'll show you how I use this approach as I'm showing in the diagram currently on screen. The assumption is that you already know how to configure an Ingress controller and cert-manager. If that's not the case, don't worry. I'm leaving you a link to a blog post where I describe step by step how you do that. So, read the blog post and come back. Now, let's start with defining the problem we're trying to solve. The issue is that not all applications are cloud native. It means that not all applications function optimally in a containerized environment. And I faced this problem in the last months with Ghost, which is an open source blog and newsletter platform that I use for my personal websites. While I managed to deploy Ghost on Kubernetes, it was evident that the tooling was not created with containers in mind. In particular, it was challenging to do upgrades and backups with the Ghost CLI. So, rather than fighting the tool, I decided to move my two blogs from the Kubernetes cluster to VMs using Terraform and Ansible. The end result is the state described in this diagram. And if you notice, I solved one issue, but I created two more. The first is that I needed to reconfigure my load balancer to direct traffic to the VMs. And that's extra work I didn't want to do, because right now I direct all traffic to the Kubernetes cluster. And the other problem is that by bypassing Kubernetes, I was losing the automated certificate management that I have set up with cert-manager, Let's Encrypt, and in my case also Cloudflare. So that was the moment I wondered, but is there a way to direct the traffic from a Kubernetes Ingress to an external application? And luckily, the answer is yes. And as an added bonus, it's also very simple. And it's incredible how you never stop learning, because despite I've been using Kubernetes for so long, I've never even thought about this approach, and it was documented right in the official Kubernetes site. In fact, if we look at the official documentation, it says that while services are mostly used to abstract access to pods, thanks to the selector, if you use them without a selector and in conjunction with an endpoint slice, you can use the service to abstract other types of backends, including those that run outside the cluster. And that's exactly what I needed. So let me show you the actual configuration I use. In terms of Kubernetes objects, we'll deal with three resource types: the ingress, service, and in my case, I'll show you the endpoints object instead of the endpoint slices, because I think it's simpler to understand. So let's start with step one. The first thing we need to create to direct traffic outside the Kubernetes cluster is a service without selector. And this prevents Kubernetes from trying to associate this service with a pod. The rest is pretty much standard. I've just a small note. If you look at the target port, that's the target port of the application I'm running outside the Kubernetes cluster. The next step is setting up an endpoint, or as we said, an endpoint slice. I prefer the former because it's simpler. The most important passage in this step is making sure that the endpoint name matches the service name. Then we define the target address and port of the application we deployed outside the Kubernetes cluster. Now, before we move to the last step, I want to show you something quick so you understand better the relationship between service and endpoints. When we define a standard service with a selector, it's Kubernetes that creates automatically the endpoints object. And I will show you this with a concrete example. So I'm going to create a deployment with three Nginx pods. I do that with the kubectl create deployment command line. Then I wait for the pods to be up and running. Once they are ready, I list them with the all white flag so I can see their IPs. Now we create a service and we use the kubectl expose deployment command. And as you can see, the service has been created correctly. Now we want to verify that Kubernetes created the endpoints for us. And as you can see, the endpoints are there and the IPs match those we listed before. I hope this clarified why we are using a service without selector in our scenario. By leaving the selector empty, we prevent Kubernetes from creating automatically the endpoints. So we have the chance to define it manually ourselves. Now that we know this, we can look at the last object, which is an ingress definition. And as you can see, it's very simple and you should be familiar with it if you already use the cert-manager. I have an annotation to select the cluster issuer that will create the certificate which is stored in the secret defined at the bottom of this resource. And then the rules is the simplest we can have. I just route all the traffic from marcolenzo.eu to the service without selector. How can we test it? I mean, in this particular case, I know it works because that's how you access my website. But to prove it to you, I'm going to change my host file and I will point marcolenzo.eu to the IP of my load balancer in front of the Kubernetes cluster. As you can see, it's a private IP. Then if I open the browser in the very same VM and type my website URL, it works as expected. And I can also check that the certificate was created correctly with Let's Encrypt. That's all for today. Summing up, we learned that not all applications are meant to run within a Kubernetes cluster. In those scenarios, it's possible to route the traffic from an ingress or service to an application outside the cluster. And by doing that, we can leverage Kubernetes as an API gateway and certificate management solution. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, I have good news for you. I'm currently recording a Kubernetes course with 9 modules and more than 30 lessons. It's going to be free. So my advice is subscribe to the channel and also the newsletter on my website to make sure that you'll be the first to know when I release the first lesson. Thank you for your time, and as usual, don't forget to like and share so that everyone can learn something new.